Good evening, dear children. Today we are going to talk about the chapter Peter Pan, right? And Peter Pan is the story about a little boy called Peter Pan. And Peter Pan was a mischievous little boy who had special abilities to fly and not to grow up. You know, he could fly and he would never grow up. And he was very fond of little children, but was little scared and not comfortable with adults, right? And Peter Pan used to often enter into little children, Wendy, Michael and John's nursery, who were the children of Mrs. Darling. Mrs. Darling and Mr. Darling had three children, John, Wendy and Michael. And these three children used to often tell about a little boy entering their nursery in the middle of the night. But Mrs. Darling never believed of all this, because their house was, you know, on the third floor of the building. And Mrs. Darling was very sure that it is not possible that anyone could enter the nursery through the window, keeping in mind the distance of the window from the ground level. That was around 30 feet, right? That was around 30 feet. On the other side, Wendy kept on telling Mrs. Darling about Peter Pan coming in skeleton leaves, and then she showed those leaves that were left behind in the nursery. Mrs. Darling was also a little upset and not sure about the little boy entering and someone entering the nursery in the middle of the night. But Wendy kept on arguing with her mother about Peter Pan coming in the house, right? And then what happened was, one night when Mrs. Darling was sewing something for Michael's birthday, that time she felt asleep and she was in deep sleep. In her dreams, she dreamt about to be in Neverland, and suddenly she woke up with a bright light entering into the nursery, right? Because she was sleeping with the children that day, and she saw a bright light, and with that bright light she could see a little boy entering the nursery, and that little boy was clad. When I use the word clad, remember, it is he was wearing a dress of skeleton leaves and juices that ooze out of the tree. And what are skeleton leaves? We know that the leaves are green. When these leaves only dry up and then the pulpy part is no more there in the leaves, they are called skeleton leaves. And Mrs. Darling was amazed, astonished and surprised to see a little boy in such kind of a dress. The most entrancing thing she saw was, what was it? She saw that the little boy had all his front teeth. You know why? Because he was so small that his baby teeth had also not fallen down. Right? So why did I tell you this story in detail? I have told you the story in detail because you should know the entire story. This is the summary of the story I told you. You also should know the summary of the story and the dialogue exchange between different characters, between the mother and Wendy, then what happened, and at the same time you should know the sequence of events, what happened first, what happened next, and in between the story what other things are discussed about, like the height of the window, the on which floor they lived, name of the child who entered. Then Wendy was a very neat and tidy child, and she was upset with Peter Pan entering the nursery with his dirty feet. Then what kind of dress he was wearing, what was mother making for Michael's birthday. All these things you should be knowing to get ready for your assessments, right? So when I say the summary, you should know the entire story from A to Z, and at the same time the different sequence of events, who said what to whom, and what, and the new words and words with special meanings, right? So like entrancing, we have tranquilly, what are skeleton leaves, what is the meaning of the word clad, what was, then you should know what was Peter Pan wearing, why was Mrs. Darling very surprised to see Peter Pan, what was the most surprising thing about Peter Pan that mother observed, What was it? The front teeth of the little boy, right? Those shining white teeth of Peter Pan. All the best for your